Navy will take on the Florida Gators here at Alumni Hall. Hi, everybody. I'm Tom McCarthy, along with Steve Lapis. Back at it again. A lot of offense in game number one. What are you expecting here in game number two?
Well, I expect to see a Florida team come out and establish the way Mike White, the new coach, wants to play. He wants to turn you over. Navy has to be very careful because if they end up in a track meet, not going to be good for them. They're going to have to handle it.
Well, speaking of Mike White, it certainly has been a transition for the Florida Gators. For 19 years, Billy Donovan was on the sidelines. Last year, they were 16-17, first time under 500. Since 1998, Donovan goes to Oklahoma City in the NBA. Mike White, off 4 years at Louisiana Tech, takes over. And one of the big things that he tried to do is build a relationship with Dorian Finney-Smith.
Well, he's got two pretty good players there. And Dorian Finney-Smith, a second-team All-SEC player last year. This kid can shoot threes. He was their leading rebounder. He is a very, very tough matchup. On the other hand, they have a terrific point guard in Casey Hill. Very athletic, great transition. Over a 2-to-1 assist to turnover ratio for his career. Not a great 3-point shooter, but when he gets out on the floor in transition, he makes his teammates better.
All right, Lap, you were here last year when Navy faced Michigan State. Michigan State was number 18 in the country, and they took him down to the wire. It was an exciting ball game, and I don't know if anybody ever expected it. That's what Navy's hoping will happen again today. Now, Tom Izzo's guys squeaked out a 5-point victory, but this place was rocking. And as we take a look at who is driven to succeed, brought to you by Continental Tire, some of the guys that had an impact last year need to have an impact again this year.
Well, Ed Zicella's told me that this program is about having seniors that are good, and these three seniors have to lead the way, especially Tillman Dunbar. He's the point guard. He's got to handle the ball and not turn it over tonight.
He's been the point guard for the last three seasons. He'll get a chance to be the point guard for a fourth consecutive year. The nightcap is upon us. It's the Gators of Florida against the Midshipmen of Navy. The tip is next.
Veterans Classic at the U.S. Naval Academy on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by AT&T, mobilizing your world, and by Continental Tire, for what you do.
Ed Zicella, the head coach of the Naval Academy, has been trying to inspire his team to play as well as they played last year against Michigan State. Well, let's hear a little bit of that inspiration.
This is our night. This is our opportunity. You gotta want it though, and you gotta play hard for 40 minutes or whatever it takes. Every possession, you gotta be focused, you gotta be dialed into what we're trying to do. Everybody got it?
It's a fun out there. Be aggressive, attack him. Family on three. 1, 2, 3. Family. Let's go.
Being aggressive was a key at shoot-around today. That's what he talked about. You see the starting lineups for both teams. We focus on Dorian Finney-Smith, but don't sleep on Devon Walker for the Florida Gators. On the flip side, we talked about Tillman Dunbar. 307 assists, 707 points in his career with the Navy Midshipmen. Mike White over from Louisiana Tech. He led his team to the NIT the last 3 years. He had a lot of success with the 2014 Conference USA Coach of the Year. So players come and go, Lauren Gardner. Coaches come and go. What has this transition been like for Mike White?
Well, they do, Tom, and in a conversation that I had earlier this evening with the young head coach, he said he wanted that transition to be as seamless as possible, and he wasn't afraid to ask for help. In fact, he had a conversation with Billy Donovan before the announcement was even made to go over the roster one by one to break down the players' personalities and some of their tendencies. He said he still talks with Donovan on a daily, sometimes hourly basis, and in fact, he actually sent him a good luck text earlier saying, Gators, we got to win this one.
Well, it is great that he uses him as a resource. Ed Zicella's is using a very seasoned assistant coaching staff as a resource for him in his fifth season as the Navy head coach. Well, these are the uniforms that the players are wearing today. Don't tread on me. It's the same style uniform that Under Armour provided for the football team for the Naval Academy. They're unveiling them tonight. We saw the shoes at practice today. They're wearing them tonight, and they may wear them again as the season moves on. In this day and age, Coach, you have to have style, and they have style with a message.
It's all about style nowadays, that's all. But you know what? Kids have always been into style. Last 20 years or so, it's been like that.
Well, here we go. Game two of the Veterans Classic is underway, and the Gators come out running right away. Allen with the layup on what looked like a design play off the tip.
They're very high on Kevon Allen. There's no doubt about it.
Arkansas Player of the Year, Gatorade High School Player of the Year. So a quick 2-0 lead for the Florida Gators. There's Tillman Dunbar, the senior from Woodbridge, Virginia. Averaged 9 points per game last year, and he has his first bucket this year.
Well, if you get a sense here of how Mike White wants to play, they all want to play at a frantic pace. You see it already. They tried to run on that made basket there by Tillman Dunbar. This team's going to try and get it up and down. And now, a little matchup zone, switching man-to-man that we saw Ed DeCellis working on with his team yesterday to make Florida throw a lot of passes, which would slow the tempo down.
I have to admit, we talked about it yesterday. We talked about it today at shoot-around. I asked you a million questions about what the heck is going on with the defense because I had no idea what it was.
Well, what I think it is, and I can't be 100% sure because Ed Chellis won't tell me, but what it looked like to me was they show a zone and then switch into, on a certain pass to the corner, into a switching man-to-man or matchup zone, because really a switching man-to-man and a matchup zone are one and the same thing.
Here's Dorian Finney-Smith. Off the foul against Jace Hogan. First team foul for the midshipman. Casey Hill hovering a little bit. Dorian Finney-Smith, he puts the ball on the floor exceptionally well. Three-pointer up top is no good, and the rebound is pulled out by the midshipman. Dunbar in transition to Anderson. Too high off the glass.
Well, that was a pretty good attack because that was a good opportunity for Navy. They've got to run. You know, when you play against... We'll call offense, we'll call palming.
Yep.
When you play against a team that presses, you have to attack. But the question is, what do you do with that 12, 13-foot jumper that's an open shot in transition? If you miss it, the tempo gets quick, and you don't really want that if you're Navy. But on the other hand, it's a pretty good shot that you might not get as good a shot in your half-court sets.
Now, they've talked about that a lot the last couple days, so we'll look at that to see what they decide to do. It looked like it was going to be it was going to depend on the situation.
I think that's it is a feel type thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If a kid feels like he's going to make it, you got to let him shoot it, but you have to be careful.
Here's Will Kelly, who's fouled on the floor. Egbuno, the transfer from South Florida. He's going to be a big-time help for the Gators.
I like him. I saw him in South Florida as a freshman. He averaged about 7 points and 6 rebounds a game. He was very solid, all freshman in the AAC. This kid's going to be a good player.
What do you think? He's 25 pounds lighter at least?
Much. He looks terrific.
So a fresh 30 on the shot clock as Tillman Dunbar will inbound. Inbounds pass goes to Will Kelly. You'll see a lot of the offense go through Will Kelly, who needs to be a good defender for the midshipman. Dunbar stumbling, staying on his feet. Here is Kelly off the glass. Good. And he's fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line.
I will say this, that right now, Florida not doing a good job of defending off the bounce. You see them getting in the lane there. You know, only bad things happen when you allow the other team to get in the lane on you. And right now, in these first 2 minutes, it looks like Navy's having really able to do whatever they want in terms of dribble penetration and creating some things.
Well, they nearly got the offensive board off the missed shot, but Dorian Finney-Smith cleans it up off the floor. 2-point lead for the midshipmen. They finished 13-19 a year ago. Picked to finish 10th in the Patriot League this year.
And you see here, this matchup zone makes you slow down and makes you kind of try to figure out what they're doing. This is switching man to man.
Yeah.
You watch everyone. Everyone's got themselves a man.
All right, so that's the second turnover for the Gators. One on a palm, that on a traveling violation.
And what Navy likes about this more than anything else is, look at how many passes they're making Florida throw. The more passes they throw, the slower they play. The slower they play, better for Navy.
That was Kevon Allen, the freshman, who was called for the traveling violation. A lot of points in game number one. A little slower start here in game two. Hogan to the corner for Anderson for three. Sean Anderson did not make a three-pointer last year as a freshman. Well, he's got that checked off his to-do list.
And now you see Navy coming out with a little 1-2-2-3 quarter court pressure.
And it's a 7-0 run for the midshipman. Casey Hill into the paint. Whistle blows and a foul on the floor. That foul will go against Will Kelly. He cannot get into foul trouble.
Well, when the ball gets close to the basket like it does there and in the lane, bad things happen. And that's why Sean Anderson is so open for his first three-point shot in 2 years.
Alade checks in for the first time. He had a big game last year against Michigan State.
And you know, let me say this about Sean Anderson. That stroke did not look like the stroke of a guy who didn't make one all last year.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Now, he has worked on it, obviously.
Now Navy in man-to-man. Let's switch it.
Did you like playing the switching man-to-man
with
you, Coach?
We did it a lot. Well, we did it a lot as part of our matchup zone. Okay. So, you know, we called it a matchup zone. Somebody else calls it switching man-to-man. It's basically the same thing.
Dorian Finney-Smith a little long with that three. Kendall Knorr with the rebound. The captain of the midshipmen leading the point. Anderson into the paint. Ball is stolen away by Casey Hill so fast. And Hill may have got away with a traveling violation, but Knorr with the rebound again.
He is ridiculously fast, by the way. And you know, you see him on tape, it's a little different than when you see him live. He is a jet quick kid.
And perfect for Mike White's system, just as he was for Billy Donovan's system.
Oh, he's going to have a lot of steals this year, there's no question, because when you're that fast, I mean, look how quick he gets his hands in there in the passing lane. I don't know, some had to be called there.
You know, it's interesting, too, as he was going toward the hoop, he hit it off his leg for a moment, and that seemed to slow his pace up a little bit. Gators fans have traveled for this ball game. Knorr thought about a three, got his man off his feet, a little short with that jumper. And Igbuno with the rebound. This is Chioza. Dorian Finney-Smith and fouled on the floor. Under 16 to play as we kick things off in the nightcap for the Veterans Classic. Navy on top after a 7-0 run. Back here at the Veterans Classic, Navy on top 7-2. We want to take a moment here to address the deadly terrorist attacks in Paris today. It is tragic events like these that serve as a stark reminder of why we are here at the Naval Academy for the start of the college basketball season, the week of Veterans Day. We take this opportunity to honor our military members and veterans for the sacrifices they make every day for our safety and freedom. We say thank you to our troops and send our thoughts and prayers to the loved ones of the victims of today's attacks in Paris. So many times over the last 2 days, each of the head coaches of the other three teams have referenced the commitment and the intellect of the MIDS and the rest of the service academies. And it was Fran Dunphy who said to us today, we need them to be that bright in times like this. We certainly have enjoyed our time here on the yard these last couple days. Lauren has been all over the place. We've gotten a chance to enjoy so much. And just listening to the coaches talk about this event as part of the start of the college basketball season. Coach, you coached for a long time. I mean, you would have embraced this kind of
event. For your kids to see this and to see how these kids live every day and do play basketball, too, is something for them to learn and to see. So it's a great opportunity for these kids and these coaches to come here and see this.
Lauren, I know that you've been around these last couple of days interacting with the players and the coaches and a lot of the MIDS as well.
And it was interesting to see them as they realize that this is about so much more than just basketball, that that's what the MIDS are here to do, to protect our country. And, you know, I thought a great quote was, hey, we're not in this to win a national championship. We're in this to protect your guys' freedom and win wars.
That is very well said. Nearly 5 minutes into this game. It's a 7-0 run still for the MIDS. Florida hasn't scored in over 5 minutes. And that continues. Allen called for the foul.
And this defense really has Florida confounded. They have not done a good job. They've turned the ball over against this defense three times in the half court set in the first 5 minutes of this game. So they're not doing a great job here of dealing with this switching man-to-man matchup zone.
Substitution for the Naval Academy. Zach Fong checks in for the first time. He's the team's leading three-point returning scorer. Bryce Doolin inbounding, just checked in a moment ago.
And they worked hard on this press offense yesterday.
They did.
Navy did.
Here's Doolin, kicks it up top to Dunbar. Florida scored with 19:57 on the clock to start the game. Over 5 minutes without a goal. Devin Robinson, part of the SEC all-rookie team, with the rebound. You're looking for big things from him this year.
Yeah, I think he's going to be a terrific player. And as I said before on the first game, guys make their biggest jump from their freshman year to their sophomore year. And I think Devin Robinson is going to do that after he throws up a semi-air ball there.
We're going to call.
If he was on cue, it would have gone into
basket. That would have been perfect. They're going to count the bucket and give it to Fong as there was contact with the backboard as this one went off the backboard. Good call.
Yep. Interesting that Navy, and a lot of people are going to go to this with that 30-second clock, go to this kind of trap, because, and now you go back to the matchup zone, and they've already made them use 10 seconds. They've got 20 seconds only against this matchup zone to work against it. So, and it's working right now.
Florida skips the pass across the court. Dorian Finney-Smith called for the
offensive foul.
That's the second offensive foul called against the Gators.
See, here's what you have to do with this defense. When you play against this defense, you have to play against it like it's a man-to-man defense and screen it and look to drive it. And right now, Florida, I think, is attacking this defense more like it's a zone. And you have to attack a matchup zone or switching man-to-man like it's a man-to-man defense with screens, just like you would in your man-to-man offense.
Well, they have forced six turnovers so far. On a 9-0 run, four baskets by four different players. Good extra pass. They decide to not take the shot.
Now, one thing about Florida, they've played 6 minutes. They only have 2 points, but Navy's only got nine. They're playing very hard on the defensive end.
Yeah, they can explode at any point. Shot clock down to three. Awkward pass. Lacey's jumper, no good. And the rebound is pulled down by Finney-Smith.
And they're getting no second shots.
Shot fake by Dorian Finney-Smith to the basket. Bucket is good. Nope, wave it off. Another offensive foul. That's the third offensive foul.
And that's a new rule, Tom.
Don't count the bucket.
The old rule, that might have been a good basket. But now the new rule is there is no such thing as a made basket. No, that would have been a regular charge anyway. But just to say it, there is no such thing as a made basket on an offensive foul. So even if you release the ball and then hit the defensive player and it's an offensive foul, it is no basket.
Well, that's the second foul for Dorian Finney-Smith, so he'll take his seat.
And that's a new rule that hasn't gotten the publicity, obviously, of the 30-second shot clock
right.
And some of the other ones. But, yes, no more offensive fouls being good baskets.
All right, and also the circle underneath has been moved up a couple of feet. So Finney-Smith will take a seat with two fouls. Ed DeChellis, though, knows how deep this Florida team is. Skyler Rimmer, 6'10" junior, checks in.
Navy's done a good job with their half-court offense. They're not scoring a lot, but they're running their stuff without turning the ball over, and that's a huge key.
Three-pointer from Zach Fong, no good, and Hill with the rebound. Yeah, if you're Navy, you're hoping you're up by a little bit more than this at this point. Francis Ramirez missed the shot, but the putback was there for the Gators.
He's very athletic, Devin Robinson. Long, athletic. He's a good three-point shooter, too.
Averaged 6.5 points per game last year. Florida turned the ball over a lot in their exhibition game against Palm Beach. But they also forced a lot of turnovers.
Yeah, 30 of them.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not forcing Navy into that many turnovers.
Here's the freshman Hassan Abdullah. Gave up his dribble in a very difficult spot. Excellent hustle by Devin Robinson. But he's termed to be out of bounds. But there's only 1 second. All right, coach, draw up a 1 second play.
Got to throw it up to the rim.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can get a shot. If somebody is completely falls asleep on Florida, you could get a jump shot off in 1 second, but you got to think it's going to be something up to the rim.
Will Kelly, Tom Lacey, they're the tallest on the floor for the Naval Academy. They get a shot off. Anderson's three is an air ball, so it's a shot clock violation.
See, Navy's doing the job on the defensive end with this, you know, very confusing defense, the 1-2-2 press, making Florida use a lot of clock, then coming down, making them make a lot of passes because they're confused against that defense. But they're not doing much on the offensive end at a time when they're holding Florida down. They need to be making hay now.
They lost 2 1,000-point scorers to graduation, and that certainly hurts. They're hoping that somebody's going to step up and take that responsibility.
Well, the odd thing about last year's game against Michigan State is they played the whole game basically without their best player, Worth Smith.
Worth Smith, right. Little touch pass to the outside for Walker, and Walker slams it home from about 7 feet away. There's a lot on that
shot.
Well,
somebody got a piece of it. That's why he basically threw it up to the basket. I don't know how that went. That was a line drive.
9-6 the score. Kelly up top between the rings. Casey Hill is hawking Zach Fong, and there's Hill's hands again. Fong's able to save it. Hassan Abdullah can't hang on. Casey Hill leads Robinson for the two-handed slam.
You just wonder, Navy's done such a good job against the pressure, Ken. This is the kind of team that will wear you out because they're so fast that you end up, if you get any kind of fatigue, they'll force 2-3 turnovers in a row and get a run on you.
Yeah, and Navy can go deep, but they can't go deep with a lot of scores. Here's Kelly inside and knocked away. Devin Robinson's been pretty active.
Well, if you want to see what the Gators are going to do under Mike White, it's get out in transition and get up. Devin Robinson, the sophomore, I think he's primed to have a terrific season. He can run the floor, and Casey Hill puts it up there right in the right place for him.
Navy hanging on to a 1-point lead. I don't know, Coach. I'm kind of tired even watching Navy's defense and the way they're matching up as we look at our eye tracker.
Well, look, every guy's got a man. I mean, they're showing zone, but everybody's playing man. And Florida's running their zone offense. There's no screening going on. So it's very, how about this? You know how easy it is to guard a guy if he's not moving that much? It's pretty easy to guard
pretty
him.
Easy.
And that's what they're doing. They're making Florida stand still, and it's easy to guard. And then they're getting back on defense. They've taken 3 charges already in this game. Right now, Edna Jones' game plan, his kids are performing that game plan better than Mike's kids right now.
But they just haven't been able to score to capitalize on it.
Yeah, I mean, they've held them to 8 points in almost 10 minutes, but they only have 9. That's because Mike White's team is playing very hard on defense also.
Shot clock was down to 4, and the Gators are able to snuff out Tillman Dunbar. Here comes Casey Hill. Hill working off the screen to Robinson. Allen has that ball knocked out of bounds. 17 on the shot clock. Casey Hill will be the trigger man. Allen with a little hop stop, and he's fouled going up. Well, Mike White likes the tempo being upbeat, Lauren. That's a part of what he's bringing with him from Louisiana Tech.
He really does, Tom. The last couple of timeouts, he game planned with his assistants and then went over to his team and he said, hey, guys, we have to increase the tempo in this game. I think he's hoping to wear the mids down and generate some offense here.
It certainly helped at Louisiana Tech. 4 years, he won 101 games. 4-year starter at Ole Miss. So he handled the ball a lot when he was with the Rebels. You're not saying anything there, Coach. Yeah.
Well, the last game of his career was against us in the NCAA tournament. Not a great night.
Well, you can laugh about
8-9 game. Oh, yeah, is that right? Who said?
No. Halfway through this first half, tied at 9. A lot of offense in game one, not so much here in game number two. Shane Anderson has 1 3-pointer so far. Tough pass to the baseline for Hogan, but Hogan converts. Jace Hogan averaged just under 4 points per game last year.
And let's understand this, Tom. I mean, Florida is trying to run even on made baskets, but that 1-2-3-quarter court press is really slowing Florida up. Look at all these passes Florida's making.
Right.
You can't play fast if you're making 6 passes, 7 passes on every possession.
Have they switched up their offense a little bit, though? Florida, have they switched their offense up a little bit?
They're trying to move a little bit more. They're trying to get a little more screening.
Yeah. Rimmer lays it in off the miss. And we're tied at 11.
They haven't really gotten a lot of effective traps. You know, well, maybe he's doing a good job of keeping the ball. Oh, that's not a good place to go. I was just going to say, they've been keeping the ball out of trap areas, and then they went to this corner of half court.
Here's Casey Hill. Bumps off Shane Anderson. No pass to Robinson. They got a nice two-man game going right now.
He's athletic.
Which one?
Devin Robinson. Casey Hill also. See, that's the shot I'm talking about. That is not
in
a
transition.
Good shot. Yeah, well, it's not a good shot because yeah. What happened is, here's what happens. Florida comes down and they do that. That's what they want. They want to make you play quick.
High,
even if you make a couple.
High back and shot by Hill makes it a 4-point lead for the Gators. Dunbar is able to break the press. Well, we mentioned that they could score quickly, and they're on a 13-2 run.
It, Navy has to stick with the game plan.
Tough pass from Hogan to Kelly, and it's going to be a backcourt violation. Nobody touched it for the Florida Gators. Egbuno checks back in for Mike White. Rimmer checks out.
Devin Robinson is standing in front. He just looks like a basketball player.
He does. 6'8", 195 pounds. He looks taller than 6'8" when you look at him.
He's very long.
Yeah.
Long arms, long legs, which makes you taller.
Gators are playing without Alex Murphy, their redshirt senior, who is out with a partially torn plantar fasciitis. That is a painful injury. They're hoping to get him back in the near future.
You see how Navy really acted, pointing and talking to each other?
Well, they made an emphasis of that today in shoot-around. And when Hogan wasn't doing it, as Hogan goes flying out of bounds, when Hogan wasn't doing it, they made it a point to remind him to do it. Now we talk about Florida's athleticism, and it can emerge at any time. And Devin Robinson has two of those that have looked rather athletic and very comfortable around the rim.
Grateful for what the Navy did for me and what I contributed to the Navy and the good of the country, yes.
Kind of our duty to maintain the standards and make sure that, you know, they didn't do what they did for nothing.
This sacrifice means everything to me, and it gives me the motivation to continue to serve for everyone else in America.
We're so thankful that we've been a part of this Veterans Classic these last 2 years and getting a chance to be on the yard to see the mids and some of the greatest basketball collegiate talent in the country. Florida Gators have now increased their lead to 6. They're on a 15-2 run the last 5 minutes.
14-6 on the glass.
Kendall Noor decides to pull it out. Gators now at 50% from the floor. Anderson trying to muscle his way in. Doesn't get the roll. Loose ball picked up by Hogan. Nice touch. They're going to need those shots. I know it seems like an easy one, but they're going to need those easy buckets.
Yeah, and they're not that easy when you're playing against an athletic team like that either. But those are the kind of baskets they got to make.
Back to the same defense for the midshipmen. And another offensive foul called against the Gators. Well, this has been a game of runs, as we've talked about, for Ed DeChellis's team. His defense stalled Mike White's offense early on, and Navy was able to jump out to an early lead. Then Mike White's team has erupted for a 15-4 run since falling behind 9-2.
You know, but they're still hanging in there, sticking with their game plan, which is important. And they've got to continue to just grind it out on offense. You know they can struggle to score against this Florida team. They just got to grind it out, and when they get something good, it's got to go in.
Here's Dunbar off the pass from Hogan. Three-pointer, no good. Ball knocked out of bounds, I believe, by Will Kelly.
Tillman Dunbar has done everything since he's been at Navy. He's been a very good player, but he's not a good three-point shooter. And that hurts, especially at that size, because you can't constantly get in the lane and score when you're at his height.
4 for 15 last year for beyond the arc. Well, here's this pressure we were talking about. Now they set the offense up with 22 on the shot clock. Now that doesn't really bother Florida that much, but didn't bother Kayvon Allen right there.
He's pretty good too. Freshman from Memphis.
And he was a big story for the Gators. Once Billy Donovan left, Mike White had to go to work to keep some of the big recruits that Billy Donovan had recruited. And he really worked to keep Kayvon Allen. Foul called on the floor. All right, so the Gators fans hope that this is something they will see a lot of in the next 4 years.
Yeah, well, Kayvon Allen jump stops into the lane. Very strong, especially in the upper body. That's why he's able to finish that.
He may have got poked in the eye as he went to the basket. So Hogan to the line, misses the first free throw. Tuesday nights at 8 Eastern, some of the most influential women in sports tackle the game's hottest topics. Don't miss We Need to Talk right here on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Just another free throw.
That you can't do.
No.
When you try and upset somebody, you got to have a good night at the free throw line.
From the corner, Walker short with his three. Kendall Knorr with the rebound. Dunbar outlet pass to Anderson.
See, I like that attack. You've got nothing, you pull it out, you run off it. So attack, maybe you get something easy. You don't, pull it out and make passes.
That's almost what Kendall Knorr was thinking, that he might get something easy. And a foul going up. Will Kelly will get a couple of free throws. Skylar Rimmer called for the first personal foul. Rimmer, who was just ruled eligible recently, the transfer from Stanford. Scholarship player at Stanford, decided to transfer back home. He grew up in Orlando. As a walk-on now with the Gators, as Kelly misses the free throw. Well, they're 0 for 4 from the free throw line. Ed DeChellis has been around for a long time. He knows that his team needs to make those free throws if they're going to pull off an upset.
There's no doubt about it.
0 for 5 from the free throw line, but Hogan gets the rebound. Here's Kendall Knorr for three, no good. Will Kelly over the back will be called for the foul. That's his second personal foul, and he's going to have to sit.
I mean, the game should be a 2 or 3 point game if they make some foul shots, not even making them all.
Alade checks back in. Alade, who started 22 games last year. You liked him in that Michigan State game.
He played great last year against Michigan State. See, now they're running the man-to-man offense, and it's much, much more difficult to match up, as you can see there. Gioza using the pick and roll there. They go under it, and he just drills it.
He averaged around 4 points per game last year. He had a great offseason, Mike White said, working on his shot, improving on his shot. Here's Dunbar. Dunbar looking down low, trying to find Alade, but he didn't get over in time. He was stuffed in some traffic. Shot clock down to 5. Hogan from the baseline. Good.
You know, Jace Hogan, he's an athletic kid, so he can kind of hang around with these Florida kids and use his athleticism. travel.
Well, they're going to call a hand checky foul. I'm with you, though. All right, so let's take a look at the Gators' last basket and what they were able to do successfully.
Well, you can take a look at this pick and roll. Stop it right there. Look at this confusion. Alane doesn't give a good hedge to come out here. That's what you got to do. You got to come out here with a good, solid hedge, and he doesn't do it. And now there's confusion. They go underneath the screen, and Chioza ends up with a 15-foot jump shot. Alane's got to do either a better job of hedging or allowing Dunbar to get around that screen a little easier.
Yeah, because Dunbar wasn't back in time.
There was confusion there.
Yeah.
It was a no man's land play, I call it. No hedge, no letting the guy get through. What's it equal? A basket.
Basket, an easy one, too. So Allen on the sidelines getting that eye checked out. Francis Ramirez, redshirted last year. They're pretty high on him as well. He missed that shot. And then here comes Abdullah, the freshman.
Yeah, they love Abdullah.
I think they feel like he's the heir apparent to Tillman Dunbar. Ball knocked out of bounds. It'll be Navy ball when we return. 3:59 to play here in the first half. Game two of our Veterans Classic doubleheader. Mids have a lot going on this weekend. They've got basketball here tonight, football tomorrow. 3:59 to play here in the first half. All right, let's take a little look at our eye tracker to see Florida's defense and transition.
Well, the athleticism of Florida is what really causes this turnover. A lot of guys with a lot of quickness and then running the floor and getting into Devin Robinson for the finish there. But Casey Hill, very, very quick hands. He gets a finger, he gets a hand on some. He's been their leader in steals. This kid in this system can really thrive. He needs to work on his jump shot. That's the biggest thing for him.
6 points off the turnover. How about Kayvon Allen, Lauren? What are you hearing?
Well, I watched the freshman come off the floor. He was having a lot of issues with his right eye. The athletic trainers took a look at it, a good examination. They put some eye drops in there. It doesn't appear to be anything serious.
Yeah, it looks better now than it did a few moments ago.
It does.
We're going to rely on him a lot for his depth. Or for their depth. Under 4 minutes to play. You see the points of the paint, that's been a big advantage for the Gators as we expected. They're 0 for 6 from beyond the arc. Here comes Chioza. Running the point. Casey Hill gets a breather. Not a great pass by Devin Robinson.
No.
Hogan off the glass, doesn't get it to go. The putback from Alade is no good. The three, no good, 0 for 7 from beyond the arc.
Yeah, he has struggled to shoot the ball. Devon Walker has a couple of years now. He was hurt last year.
Yeah, came down with a knee injury in July of last season, so missed the entire year. Dueling with his entry pass to Alade. Alade backing his way in, trying to get some positioning, tight quarters. And another rebound for the Gators. A three is good. He gave him a little bit of a space and he was able to connect.
Yeah, they went under the screen again and he just pulled up there. And he played a lot for them last year.
Out of Memphis, Tennessee. 9-point lead. It's a 15-4 run for the Gators. Abdullah, well, he lost control of that one, and Chioza picked his pocket pretty clean. Heading to the rim, an easy layup.
Well, he went into a really bad spot there. He drove in the middle of the floor where all the help was.
All right, so Chioza off the bench has been helping these Gators with a little offense.
Well, what happens is you end up losing it because the pressure wears you out. Chioza there knocking down the three when they go underneath the screen. And here off their great defense, which has been terrific in the half court, and now starting to turn them over.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, Brent Stover, Doug Gottlieb, and Pete Gillen from our New York studios. A look around college basketball, plus first half highlights and statistics. Not a lot of offense in this first half here, but we've watched Chris Chioza score Florida's last 7 points. Florida's bench has scored 17 points in this first half.
They're deep. We knew that coming into the game.
Maybe trying to answer. Good defense by Casey Hill.
They're playing really hard.
Hogan down low to Alade, and Alade is able to move from one side to the other and then back again to lay it in. Hogan's had a good first half. He has scored and he was a facilitator there. Here's Hill against Dunbar, knifing through some traffic. Whistle blows, ball knocked out of bounds by Alade. All right, so Hogan scored along the baseline, but here he was more of the distributor.
Well, he does a great job there of driving into the lane. Skylar Rimmer, though, takes his eye off his man and is looking at the... You always must see the ball and your man at all times. That time, Rimmer lost his man. That's why they ended up getting that layup.
Hey, another turnover now for the Gators. Even though they have a 26-17 lead, they have turned the ball over 10 times in this first half.
I mean, this defense, this is the kind of thing when you're a coach, you look at the game plan. The game plan has been good. They're not losing because the game plan is not working. They're losing because they can't struggle and they can't score in a half court. But their defense has done what it was supposed to do, or what, put this way, if you told Edgy Tellis they're going to have 26 at halftime, he would have taken that in a second.
Absolutely. Game clock under one, shot clock under 10. Dunbar into the land of giants, off balance shot, but Alade is there to lay it back in.
Well, it's amazing dribble penetration, even bad dribble penetration, can lead to something good. Somebody comes over to help, and Alade ends up being able to clean it up.
And another offensive foul called against the Gators. That time it was Skylar Rimmer who moved. That's the fifth offensive foul.
Yeah, Mike White cannot be happy with all these turnovers.
All right, so if you're Navy, there's a 7-second difference around there between the shot clock and the game clock. 11 turnovers, 5 offensive fouls for the Gators in this first half.
Well, they got to take this thing down as far as they can.
Yep. And hope that they can connect on a bucket.
And at the worst, don't let Florida score on the last possession.
Shot clock is down to 5. Here's Fong, fakes the three, now takes the three, short. And Robinson brings it up the floor. He's got time to go. Robinson right to the rim, draws the foul and makes the basket. Worst case scenario, Coach.
Tough play and a big play, exactly. It's the worst case scenario for Navy. But they missed that shot and they can't come down. Not only do they not stop him, but they give him an and one.
Not much Dunbar can do. Alade probably should have stepped up and not floated back. Robinson to the free throw line, connects.
You feel a lot different being down 7 than 10.
So it's a 10-point lead for the Gators. One last opportunity for Navy. No good. It would have countered if Kendall Knorr had connected. But the Gators extend their lead to 10, 29-19. Lauren Gardner is with Mike White. Lauren?
Well, Coach, Navy's matchup zone has presented some problems for you guys early on. What adjustments did you make?
Well, through substitution, you know, first of all, we tried to find a couple different guys that might be able to help us. I thought Chris Chioza came in and gave us some good minutes. I thought Devin Robinson played with a bunch of energy, got some hard rebounds. But really, most of our offense, without looking at the film, has come from our defense.
And you may need some of that depth. You've had some issues with offensive fouls. How do you address that with your guys in the locker room?
Just continue to stress it is all we can do. You know, with the freedom of movement and the new emphases with the officials, they're doing the best that they can, to hold each other and themselves accountable. And we've got to continue to learn how the game is being officiated. We've got to clean it up a little bit.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Well, Mike White was talking about the bench play. Robinson and Chioza, 16 points combined. Coming up after the break, it's AT&T at the half. You're watching the Veterans Classic, game number 2 on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. For nearly 70 years, the Marine Corps Silent Drill Platoon, based in Washington, D.C., has gone around the world, just as they've done here tonight, showing off their skills, and they are mad. It's been impressive to watch, not only in game 1 of halftime, but also game 2. Watch this action right here. That'll keep everybody nice and quiet. A 10-point lead for the Florida Gators, along with Steve Lapis. I'm Tom McCarthy. All right, we've been raving about the Navy defense. This was more about a lack of offense for them and the reason they're down by 10.
Or you could say that Florida played very good half-court defense. So, you know, give them credit that when they couldn't score, they also were stopping Navy from scoring, and then they had their spurt, and that's why they're sitting here with that 10-point lead now.
Great bench play for the Florida Gators, including Devin Robinson, who showed his athleticism and showed it almost immediately once he came off the bench.
Well, we talked about him early. This kid was an all-SEC freshman last year, and we talk about it all the time, how a kid makes his biggest jump between his freshman and sophomore year. And this is a kid with a big upside who is going to make a big jump this year. A very important guy for Mike White.
Our Kawasaki first half statistics. Florida, they turned the ball over 11 times, but they still have the lead, but they turned it over 11 times.
And that's thanks to the game plan and the Navy defense. Navy, on the other hand, 0 for 5 from the free throw line and 1 for 6 from 3. That's not going to get it done against a team from the Southeastern Conference.
All right, so we get set to begin the second half with the Gators on top by 10, 29 to 19. Lauren Gardner got a chance to catch up with Ed DeCellis. What did he say, Lauren?
Well, Tommy was very positive. He said he was happy with the way his defense has played. But, Coach, like you said, 0 for 5 from the free throw line. He said, we have to make free throws if we want to win this. And we have to make one-foot shots. He said, when you're playing a team that is long and as athletic as the Gators, every little thing counts.
It's kind of interesting. During shoot-around today, they were going over their stretching. And Ernie Nestor, their former head basketball coach at George Mason, one of the assistants on Ed DeCellis' crew, was barking out numbers of all the players. And the players would then have to give the scouting report on those players. They were ready to go, but they did talk about the fundamental part of it, the little shots and the free throw shots.
Still, the game still comes down to making enough baskets. You can do what you can have a great game plan and stop the other team, but you've got to score on the other end. That's the problem for Navy right now.
Dorian Finney-Smith had his pocket picked on that one. Here comes Tillman Dunbar. Finney-Smith was out for most of the first half with two personal fouls. Will Kelly in the paint trying to get on track off the front of the rim. Allen, the freshman. Ball is knocked away for a moment. Does Allen's presence give Hill a chance to play off the ball a little bit more, you think?
I don't think so. I think Casey Hill has got to have the ball in his hands. That's what makes him effective, because he's not a good shooter. He's the kind of guy who makes his teammates better. He's been terrific with his assisted turnover ratio since he's been there. He's an assist. He's had 10 assists or more two or three times in his career. He's an assist guy. He's got to have the ball in his hands.
Well, Dorian Finney-Smith still trying to get on track. He does not have a point here tonight. He just missed that shot there. Here's Kendall Knorr, and the ball knocked out of bounds. It'll remain Navy basketball with 21 on the shot clock. Well, Florida's kind of opened the door here for Ed DeCellis' team to get back into it.
They just put the problem is they're not really even getting good opportunities right now. I mean, this Florida team is so athletic, they can make it very hard for you to score.
Dunbar covered by Casey Hill up top. Here's Hogan, left side of the lane. Dorian Finney-Smith is so long, it's tough to get a shot off, and he misdirected that one. Here comes Allen to Hill, has it stripped away, and it will be Navy ball. It went off the leg of Casey Hill.
They're trying to push the tempo, trying to get themselves some easy baskets, but, you know, give Navy credit.
A little pressure put on by the Gators.
This game is going to come down to, can Navy score enough to beat this Florida team? Because they've got the game plan. They're doing everything they need to do. Just right here in the half court, they really don't know where to go.
Dunbar forces the pass inside. It's knocked away by Casey Hill. I think that's a prime example of what you just said right there on that particular possession. Neither team has scored in the second half. Casey Hill from the free throw line, short. Dorian Finney-Smith, though, with the rebound, finds Hill cutting to the basket. He can't get the layup to go down. And now a jump ball, and the possession will remain with the Gators.
I mean, Dorian Finney-Smith, this kid has been a really good scorer for a couple of years, and he just can't get anything going at all.
If Florida's going to do anything in the SEC, he is going to have to be a focal point. Averaged over 13 points per game last year. He's at 899 points for his career.
I think Florida's problem this year is going to be what Florida's problem was last year. When they're in the half court, they're going to struggle to score because they don't really have a lot of three-point shooters. If they're not in transition, it's going to be hard for them to score. Last year, they only averaged 63 a game.
Third personal foul for Kelly, and Allen will go to the free throw line. Mike White was not feeling good about the way his team had practiced after yesterday's practice for the last 5 or 6 days.
Yeah, he wasn't happy.
They felt good today.
We talked about it, you know what I mean, how at this time of year, I think your team wants to play somebody else.
Right.
You're tired of playing against each other. You're practicing for so long. Time to get somebody else out there. And sometimes you just have bad practices. I mean, it just happens. And I can't tell you how many times we had a bad practice, I played great the next day, and how many times we had a great practice, I played lousy the next day. So if there's some formula, I would love to. I'd pay for it.
You'd bottle it.
Anybody would bottle it and buy it. Any coach in America would buy it.
Two made free throws, 31-19 off the foul by Will Kelly. We mentioned it's his third. So he can't get into foul trouble. There's a carry by Bryce Doolin.
I mean, look at it. This has been like, you know, this has been like slow torture, really, for Navy, because they've only given up 2 points in the whole half, yeah. And they're down 12.
Here's Finney Smith, puts it on the floor, goes to the basket, draws the foul, so he'll go to the free throw line. That may give him a chance to get himself going a little bit, getting some free throws. He was just a 59% free throw shooter. Florida, in their scrimmage against Palm Beach Atlantic, they were 10 of 27 from the free throw line.
Yeah, that does not bode well.
Kenny Smith with his first point of the night. And he makes both. The lead is up to 14 for the Gators. Pressure off the made free throw.
Aggressive pressure in the full court.
And Navy expected this. They worked on it a lot today.
They knew what was coming.
Tough to simulate it with the athletes the Gators have.
And I'm sure they watched a lot of Mike White's games when he was in Conference USA at Louisiana Tech. So that's really what they had to go by.
Roland gives up the three opportunities. Shot clock is under 10. Dunbar into the paint. There's a lot of traffic going on there, and he's going to go to the free throw line. The foul is going to go against Casey Hill. That's his second. And Tobin Dunbar will go to the free throw line. Now the first big free throw of the night for the midshipmen. They were 0 for 5 in the first half. And a lane violation. I think the Gators were anticipating that. Somebody looked like they signaled a Tim Valentine. The violation was called on Alade. Now a steal by Anderson.
That was a terrible pass by Dorian Finney Smith.
Doolin feeds it inside for Hogan. Anderson wants a screen. Goes to the corner for Doolin for three. Good! I'll wake everybody up a little bit here.
Well, some good offense there. Drew a penetration and a kick to the corner.
Back to a 10-point game. Hill tries to answer and does. Egbuno with a big slam. 35-23. Dunbar trying to draw the contact. Touch off the glass, no good. Loose ball picked up by Finney Smith. That was just a little unlucky. Here's Allen for three. No good, it rimmed out. Anderson to Dunbar, back to Doolin. Second three attempt short this time. Casey Hill wants to run. His bounce pass to Allen is cut off and saved by Hogan. Or by Doolin, excuse me. Here comes Anderson. His bounce pass went to the Gators.
this is an exchange where nothing is happening.
A jump ball and the ball goes to the midshipman.
I was quiet because I'm watching go back and forth and really nothing was going on.
You wanted to take your dry erase board out. This is what you might lay out for the Gators to work with. A good pass and a good shot.
Florida over Navy, and it's been a fun couple of days here at the second annual Veterans Classic here in Annapolis. Yesterday, three of the visiting teams took a tour of the Naval Academy and got to see some of the more fun aspects of being a midshipman. I came along for the ride, too. I wasn't about to miss out on all the fun. We were able to jump in some Humvees, wear some helmets, and some bulletproof vests, even check out a helicopter in a real ship. And guys, get this, there's a ship simulator here at the Academy. Everyone got a chance to drive, and I hate to say it, but UNC ended up crashing.
We saw that shot of Justin Jackson, and he was sort of simulating how tall he is and how small the quarters are where he was standing. How'd you do with the ship simulator there, Lauren? Would you do okay with it?
You know, I did try my hand at it.
Uh-huh. That's it, huh? That's all you got?
I'll just leave it at that. It's harder than it looks.
I would think so. Some of the Florida players were talking about it and how I think it was Casey Hill who may have crashed the ship. Doolin has that ball knocked away. David Robinson checks back into the ball game. Well, the bench was the big story for the Gators in the first half.
Well, Gios and Robinson really brought tremendous energy off the bench.
13 on the shot clock for the midshipmen as they inbound here. And a three-point attempt by Ryan Pearson is no good. Casey Hill runs down the rebound. Here's Walker. Right side of the lane, sweeps in, no good. Rebound is pulled down. And the Gators get an easy bucket from Egbuno. And he'll go to the free throw line to try to finish off a three-point play.
I think Egbuno has a chance to be a really, really good player. Now, I don't know, I think he might have pushed somebody in the back there, but that was still a good finish with the left hand. He's a little raw, but he can get some things done in the low post.
Born in Nigeria. Again, he went to USF when Stan Heath lost his job. That's when he transferred. Sat out last year. Was practicing with the Florida Gators. And he's helped the Gators to a 14-point lead. Here's Pearson, the freshman. Doolin dribbles into a double team. Nearly lost control. The shot clock is winding down. Dunbar will reset things. Dunbar for three, and it's no good.
That was a really good defensive set by Florida that time.
Yep. Robinson with a shot fake. Now to Walker. Francis Ramirez from the corner. A little too strong with that one. And a foul called on Devin Robinson.
You know, I think they got to go to Egbuno a little bit more. I mean, I'd like to see him get the ball in the low post. I mean, they don't really seem to look for him in the post.
Yeah, whoever the big man is, now, this time it's Will Kelly. Now, Kelly's known as a very good defender, but he still has a lot of size on Will Kelly.
Oh, yeah, this kid is, you know, much more athletic.
Kavarius Hayes, the freshman, checks back in for Florida for the first time in this half. Now the Gators, they did say they would go deep tonight, and they certainly have.
Well, the story of the game has been their half-court defense, that Navy has not been able to get anything in the half court. They've been locked in pretty much the whole game.
Now, I guess it's tough to say, but you have a pretty good gauge of this kind of stuff. Will that can that carry over to the SEC with the way they're playing?
Oh, yeah. I mean, this team is capable of playing really good defense because if you're athletic and you're quick, that's a good start.
Yeah.
And they're well-schooled in the half court.
Kelly's shots have been short for Navy.
And let me say this. A lot of times teams that like to press aren't that well-schooled in the half court defensively because you spend so much time on your pressure. Well, this team is well-schooled at playing half court defense also. And you got to give Mike White credit for that. I think it's hard to be a pressing team and play good half-court defense, but they are doing it.
You see the five on the floor for the Gators. Robinson looking inside. Nothing is there. And now a foul call against Will Kelly.
They have similar problems to Navy, but on a different scale. Their half-court offense isn't great either. Obviously, they have better players than Navy has, but in the league, they're going to have to score in the half-court. If they're not forcing turnovers,
right.
I'm watching them saying, well, how are they going to score? Because Casey Hill is not that effective in the half-court. He's at his best when it's up and down. So if it's a half-court game, he's almost out of the game.
By the way, I'll correct myself. That was Tom Lacey was called for that foul. At Florida, 2 of 9 shooting in this half, but Navy 1 of 10. Francis Ramirez along the baseline. Finds Hill in the corner, and Hill to Chioza up top for three. No good. But Robinson's there for the offensive board.
I got to tell you, Boone was working very hard, was working very hard when he was in the game in the low post trying to get open. They weren't even looking at him.
Yeah, Hayes is doing the same thing right now.
He's working hard.
Here's Francis Ramirez for three. Too long. Tillman Dunbar got his hands on it, and it's knocked into the hands of Pearson. Pearson for three, no good. He's missed two threes. Lacey has his shot blocked away. The dual and putback is no good, but then a foul called under the basket. So Navy will get two free throws here with 12:35 to play. Devin Robinson wound up over toward the doors leading to the locker room. I don't even know if a shot fake would have helped there. He tried it. Lacey tried it. Well, Devin Robinson went over toward those doors because it looked like he injured his arm. So Bryce Doolin will get two free throws. And he makes his first. The road to the Final Four continues on CBS Sports Network Sunday at 1 Eastern as the ACC's Demon Deacons of Wake Forest travel to Lewisburg to take on the Bison of Bucknell right here on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. A good offensive board by Lacey. Putback is good. He gets the roll.
Devin Robinson completely fell asleep there.
37-26, 12:25 to play here in the second half. Florida able to break the press. Casey Hill dribbles it right on out of bounds, though. 16 turnovers for the Gators. Now, their defense will fly in the SEC, but again, they got to figure out the turnovers.
Yeah.
16 is just way too many.
Way too many.
It is game number one, but still. They have one more turnover than field goal. Well, Navy can make this a single-digit game. Pearson with the three-point fake inside to a cutting Kelly. Well, you talked about Egbuno. Well, he's starting to play in there, and there's another block shot for him.
Yeah, he's a very aggressive kid, athletic, and just learning really how to play.
You wonder if the year out may have helped him practicing and going over all those things.
Oh, I think it does. I think it does. And he's much more comfortable, obviously, playing for Florida, having practiced the stuff for a year, even though he's a different coach now, too. But just being with the guys helped.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Dunbar just realized that he'll let a three fly. No good. Shot clock violation. 11:47 to play here in the second half. Florida hanging on to a 37-26 lead. Midshipman defense has been tough, but so has the Gators defense in tonight's ballgame. We recap with the AT&T game summary. The Navy midshipmen shooting just 26% in this entire ballgame. Bench points go to the Gators. They have 20 bench points. They've also out-rebounded the Gators by 9. Now, we talked about Navy's defense being good, but the Florida defense has been very good. As we take a look at our eye tracker, we'll be able to show you how good that defense is.
Well, they force 26% because they do a good job of helping, as they do here, and they stay active. They don't just get in there and help. They're active help looking to make steals. And you're going to see right here a situation where they trap on the pick and roll a little bit, and they step up into the passing lane and end up forcing a steal and getting transition. So this team is very active. Quick hands, athletic. They make it hard for you to score in a half court.
Now, on the flip side, their defense has been good, both defenses, but offensively, both teams have been challenged, particularly in the second half, only 15 combined points in the second half.
I mean, this Florida team did not score last year. They were 16
right.
and 17 for that reason. So the question is, are they going to score more this year? I really think they got to get Ibuna more involved, because that's a source of points, I think, that they have not used. They haven't had, they didn't have a big guy last year in there who could score. I think he's capable of making some baskets inside.
And then the obvious statement, too, is Dorian Finney-Smith, who's been quiet tonight, needs to get his points as well. Shot clock is down to two. Francis Ramirez for three. Good! And their lead is up to 14. And now the pressure by the Gators. Abdul and Pearson, both freshmen, on the floor for the midshipmen.
I think it's getting near time where Navy needs to be more aggressive against the pressure than they've been.
Dual and aggressive, try to get to the cylinder, and his shot is no good. And then Lacey's putback is no good. But the Gators called for the foul. Well, right, so shot clock was winding down here.
Right, it drew penetration, though, and then allowed Chioza to be too open, especially a guy who's made a couple of shots in this game.
It's a non-shooting foul, so the midshipman will get a fresh 30. Abdul, bounce pass off the leg of Lacey. Well, this is where Tillman Dunbar, not being on the floor, even though he doesn't score a whole lot, he usually settles the offense. Shot clock under 10. Pearson to the corner. Shot clock at 5. Doolin tried to bank it. I don't think he tried to do that, but it hit off the backboard. And it'll be Florida ball.
If he was trying to bank that, I'm going to say he
ever
should.
Play, ever play horse before?
He would need to be on America's Got Talent. If he could bank it from where he was by trying to.
I was giving him the benefit of the doubt.
I'm sorry, Tom. I kind of blew you up there a little bit. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that.
Dunbar checks back in. So does Hogan. Vinny Smith working the backcourt with Chioza. Francis Ramirez. Devin Robinson. And Ibuna.
I would like to see Ibuna get the ball once and make a move.
Here's Robinson for three. Ibuna gets the rebound. And he dribbled it off the leg, off his leg.
Once a big guy brings the ball down, it's bad. It's a trouble.
We've heard that since kids were 7, 8 years old picking up the game. Halfway through the second half. Hogan's been quiet in the second half. Here's Anderson, has it stripped away by Chioza. He's got numbers, leaves it for Francis Ramirez, and now Dorian Finney-Smith with the easy slam.
They get up pretty quick.
They do. And the lead is up to 16, 4 points for Dorian Finney-Smith. He was held under 10 points only 6 times last year. Anderson open for three. And he rattles it home.
He's played well. I mean, he's pitching for a guy who last year didn't make a three.
He was 0 for 13 last year from beyond the arc. Ball is kicked out of bounds. They isolated him off to the corner.
That's defense was lacking there big time.
So Shade Anderson makes it a 13-point game. Keyvon Allen checks back into the ballgame for the Gators. Casey Hill is back on the floor. So it's Finney-Smith, Hill, Keyvon Allen, Devin Robinson, and Skyler Rimmer for the Gators. Boy, Allen must have been a menace in high school last year. The shot clock winds down at 2. Hill, and his pass down low to Rimmer, and Rimmer is able to bank it off the glass.
Good pass.
Yep, Anderson can't finish. Allen came over, caused a little bit of a problem, but he still could have finished that one. Robinson for three, no good. But the putback by Rimmer.
You know, Robinson has played well, but he has not shot the ball from three-point line well. He made threes last year.
Mm-hmm. Well, Skyler Rimmer gets the last two field goals for the Gators. Their lead is up to 46-29 with 8:17 to play here in the second half. Robinson tried another three off the mark, but Skyler Rimmer was there for the putback for the Gators. 46-29, the Florida Gators on top of the Navy midshipman, and Mike White's debut as the head coach of the Florida Gators. We flash back, we alluded to this before. Man, the hair is looking good back in 1999. There's Mike White, his Ole Miss squad, seeking their first ever win in the NCAA tournament. Their opponent was Laps Villanova Wildcats. White did not score any points in the game, but did have a game-high 7 assists as Ole Miss won it 72-70. You told me before...
Memory lane. You bring back the good memories. You don't bring back the bad ones.
Well, you told me before that you told Fran Dunphy that he would remember every loss when he was in the Army. And you have still, the first thing you said to Mike White yesterday was about that game. That's the first thing you said to him when you saw him yesterday.
Yes. And that is true.
By the way, the hair looked really good back then. It slipped back nice.
I was a little younger.
Weren't we all? Weren't we all? He was a good player, though, wasn't he?
He was a good player. Yes, very good player. And Rod Barnes was a very good coach. They were very good defensively.
That's where he cut his teeth as an assistant coach, was at Ole Miss. Was there for a number of years before getting the Louisiana Tech job. Thought it was interesting reading some of the articles when he was hired at Florida. As Shane Anderson goes to the basket, no good. Fresh 30 is Navy hustling all over the floor as Anderson goes hard to the court. And we've got a timeout. 7:50 to play here in the second half. Ed DeChellis and the midshipmen trying to solve the Gators' defense. Game two of our Veterans Classic. Florida on top 46-29. Tomorrow, join CBS Sports Network as we shift to the gridiron for four games of college football, highlighted by Keenan Reynolds and his chase of the all-time FBS rushing touchdown record as 20th-ranked Navy hosts SMU at 3:30, followed by 22nd-ranked Temple at USF, presented by Geico at 7 o'clock, only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Keenan Reynolds is on the cusp of passing Monte Ball for the most touchdowns, rushing touchdowns, each with 77. Boy, he's a special player. I mean, he is a special player. He has been fun to watch. I thought Ricky Dobbs was fun to watch as the quarterback for Navy. 46-29. Sean Anderson with the ball. He has 6 points for the midshipman and the foul on Dunbar. Devon Walker called for the personal foul. Devon Walker coming off that knee injury, which he sustained in July of last year. He looks like he's moving pretty well.
Yeah, he's moving well, but he's not a good shooter.
No.
He's kind of like, I'm not sure where he fits in. He's a great athlete, he's a good defender.
Tillman Dunbar makes this a 15-point game. Well, the bench for Florida has been a big key to their success tonight. 27 points off the bench. Robinson puts it on the floor, caught in some traffic. Casey Hill with three on the shot clock. And that's more his speed as far as the mid-range jumper goes.
That's what he does. He's very good with the floater. You saw that he didn't really want to settle for the jump shot. He only took a few threes last year. He doesn't even take them. So that's what he's got to make. He's got to make those little floaters in the lane or get out in transition.
8 made threes last year for Casey Hill. 8 of 29. Sean Anderson with the ball out front.
They've done a great job in this game of closing out on shooters. Even when they get beat off the dribble, they get out to shooters very quickly.
That was not an easy shot by Jace Hogan. He has 8 points. Most of those points coming in the first half. The freshman Hassan Abdul is at the scorer's table. He's about to check back into the ballgame for the mids. Hill to the basket. Fouled going up by Hogan. Three fouls on Hogan, who had the last basket for the midshipman.
Well, Jace Hogan has been very effective in this game. He's able to put the ball on the floor. He's pretty strong. makes that little spin move, dips his shoulder, and he's able to make create enough space to make that shot.
How are they going to fare in the Patriot League, Coach?
Well, I mean, they're picked 10th right now. Obviously, they lost a lot from last year. Two really good scorers. But I think this league is so much balance, you never know. Bucknell's picked first. Lehigh's picked second. Well, they're picked as the top two teams in the league. They've had a lot of success lately. But I think it's the kind of thing where in a league like this, it's wide open. Anybody can do it. And you know what it really comes down to? 3 days in March. That's really all that matters. You know what I mean? Is what happens during the tournament in March. And getting home games obviously makes a difference, because that's how it works in this league in terms of your seed.
48-33, 5:45 to play in the second half. Casey Hill fouled by Will Kelly. That's his fourth personal foul. All right, so the Patriot League preseason poll, Lehigh number one, Bucknell number two, Boston University, watch them. And Army is thought to have a pretty good roster coming into the season.
Yeah, they were a little disappointing last year. I think people thought more of Army last year, but you know, they picked fourth this year. So, but again, it's going to be a wide open league. No one is that much better than anybody else.
We'll get a chance to see Bucknell on Sunday here at CBS Sports Network. They take on Wake Forest. Casey Hill converts the free throw. Francis Ramirez is in a little bit of pain. We're going to buddy tape those fingers together. Hill makes both free throws. So he has 6 points.
They played Chioza and Hill together considerably last year. And I think they're going to play them a lot together this year, even though both are point guards. Mm-hmm. Chioza could shoot the ball, so he could play off of it.
The lead is up to 17 for the Gators. Hassan Abdullah for three. It's an air ball. And here's Dorian Finney-Smith.
I know they're very high on Abdullah, but he has not looked good tonight.
Robinson from the corner, it's good as he falls to the floor. And the lead is up to 20. It's the first 20-point lead of the night for the Gators. Points for Robinson off the bench, and Chioza is called for the foul on Sean Anderson.
Well, this is just a matter of a guy being, I mean, Abdullah is closing out. Abdullah's all about 6 feet, closing out on Devin Robinson, who's 6'8". I don't think that kind of a contest is going to bother a guy like that, and that's why he was able to make that shot.
Anderson goes to the free throw line. Anderson, who last year led the freshman Navy's roster in minutes played. Takes the first.
I mean, Navy's issue is what Ed Dichelis told us. You know, how are they going to score? And they've got it. They obviously have a lot of time to get better. They're going to need to get better. They have some pieces.
Yeah.
And these guys are all in new roles because of the guys they had last year, Venerini and Warren Smith. Those guys were doing a lot of the scoring for them. So somebody else is going to have to step up, and everybody's going to have to do a little bit more.
Yeah, Worth Smith is in Norfolk after graduating, and Venerini is in Rhode Island.
Yes, you go. I got it.
Both are ensigns now in the United States Navy. Finney-Smith with a shot fake.
I mean, they work hard, they play good defense, they do the things that you want, but you just gotta make baskets. That's what they have to figure out. Where are they gonna make baskets from?
Dorian Finney-Smith has that ball off his leg and out of bounds. Nope, they're going to say that Navy touched it last. So 25 on the shot clock. Officiating crew, Ted Valentine, Jamie Lucky, Tim Clogarty, another outstanding trio of officials, just like the first game.
We've had the six of the best refs in the country have been here tonight.
Chioza goes to the corner for Allen. Robinson for three. No good. And Fong is able to save the ball on the sideline. Well, he's fortunate he didn't get hurt. Sean Anderson into the paint.
Robinson. It's tough.
Tough on the offensive end, tough on the defensive end.
He's going to have to be, hopefully a more consistent shooter than he's been.
Well, you talked about the importance of some freshmen, the higher end freshmen like Robinson, making that jump from freshman to sophomore. Is that the biggest jump for
him? Oh, no question. You know what I mean? You look at guys, the guys that finished strong at the end of last year, like a Justin Jackson and guys like that. You have to feel good about them coming into their sophomore year, because what happens is, too, when you play as a freshman, you've never played college basketball, obviously, so you don't even know what to expect coming in. So finally, as a sophomore, you know what to expect.
Right.
And that makes a huge difference in terms of you being ready to play from the beginning. You know how fast the game is. You know what you need to do.
You know what your offseason is supposed to be like.
You know everything. Done it once. It makes a huge difference. Mentally and physically makes a difference. Plus, you get a lot stronger from your freshman to your sophomore.
Here's Fong for three. No good. And the Gators pull down the board.
Like I said, though, I would like to see Egbunu get get some more touches in the half court. Mm-hmm. See what he can do.
Foul on the floor. Robinson fouled on the floor. Florida has increased its lead. It was at 20 at one point. It's sitting at 19. 3:26 to play here in the second half of the Naval Academy.
Veterans Classic at the U.S. Naval Academy on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by AT&T, mobilizing your world.
Well, if you ever come down to Annapolis, there's a million different restaurants that you can go along Main Street, and you can find whatever you want to have for dinner. You'll find it there. It's a beautiful place, and we have certainly enjoyed the last couple of days. Coming up next, we head to the studios. Our panel of experts break down the night from the Veterans Classic and around the nation on Inside College Basketball right here on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Hello, Steve Lapis and Lauren Gardner. I'm Tom McCarthy. John Rothstein is here as well. Enjoyed having John around these last couple of days. Robinson makes the free throw.
Taught us something about eating, I'll tell you that.
Yes, he did. Also very impressed when you would name a year where your teams would play in the NCAA tournament. He would tell you who you played in what region and everything.
And the score.
And the score. Was pretty remarkable. Points of the paint. Florida 26, Navy 16. That's been a factor tonight. Here's Abdullah. And the ball is knocked away. 20-point lead, 3:09 to play. Here's Abdullah, right side of the lane, off to the basket. Shot is blocked, but they'll call it goaltending.
That was two pretty good moves in a row. Yeah. I don't know if those balls would have gone in the basket had they not been goaltended, but they were pretty good moves, pretty quick to get by the Florida defenders.
What do you want to accomplish if you're Navy in these last 3 minutes?
You want to keep playing hard and, play the defense the way you've been playing it, and hopefully try and, maybe like a guy like Abdullah get some confidence in the last 4 minutes of this game, because he did not look good for most of the game, and now his last couple of plays were pretty good.
Well, that's another offensive foul called against the Gators. Abdullah running the point. Tillman Dunbar has been on the bench the last few minutes. And a steal by Casey Hill. And now Hill into the open floor. He is fast. Oh, man. Explodes to the rim.
Yeah, that was a bad play by Abdullah there. Even though he's probably not going to play against somebody as quick and as athletic as Hill in the Patriot League, but still, that's not a good pass.
And another turnover. Allen, the freshman, goes right to the rim with his left hand, and the lead is back to 20. That matches the largest lead of the night for the Gators, under 2 minutes to play. Mike White was very concerned about this matchup because the way his team was practicing. Obviously, he wants to get his career as the Gators head coach off on a good note. I think he should be proud of his team's defense tonight.
Yeah, no doubt. I don't think we saw the style that
no.
he hopes to play.
Well, Mike White, there's a lot of players and coaches who have affiliation with the military. And Mike White's father-in-law, Julius Shao, was a captain in the United States Navy, 3 decades a captain in the United States Navy. Getting a chance to see his son-in-law as the head coach of the Florida Gators. We thank him and all of the veterans for all that they do to protect our nation. Looks like his mother-in-law is really into the action here.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
You're up 20 with 1:38 to go. I think you can sleep well tonight.
Finney Smith to the line again, and he misses again, so it's still a 20-point game.
Yeah, like I said, it's not going to be the style. This is not the style Mike White wants to play,
right.
But they did what they had to do, which is play good half-court defense tonight when other things weren't working.
And they understood what happened last year at Michigan State.
Oh, yeah.
They
knew he showed that tape.
Yep, that Navy took them down to the wire. Fong's first three of the night. 58-41. Chioza. Allen from the corner, no good. And Abdullah leads the break. Hempel was the guy who was going to get that pass, but it was cut off. Tavarius Hayes, the freshman, cut that off. James Hempel, the junior from Raleigh. 103 to play. Abdullah launches the three. And Hempel with the rebound, and he's fouled going up, so he's going to go to the free throw line. Dorian Finney-Smith called for the personal foul.
It seems to me in this kind of game, Navy was only able to score on kind of like, you know, aggressive offensive rebounds. They couldn't get their anything really out of the straight offense.
Right.
It was more opportunistic baskets, and they're going to have to work on where they're going to get points from.
Hempel, this is the first free throw. Allen checks out. Lex Edwards checks in for the Gators. Hempel's second free throw, no good. He's battling for the rebound, and he's going to be called for the personal foul with 54 seconds to play.
The free throw shooting by Navy. When you struggle to score points, you're going to shoot free throws like that. You're really going to struggle.
Yeah, they are at 3 for 11 from the free throw line. Lex Edwards, left-handed shooter, misses the first. And makes the second. 50 seconds to play here in the second half. Francis Ramirez gets the rebound. Twenty-seven seconds to play here in the second half. Mike White was trying to get Zach Hoskins into the ball game. I want to see a guy that works his tail off at practice. Hoskins is that guy. Shot clock goes off, but the rebound for the Gators, they'll just hold on to it. So the Mike White era gets off the grounds with a victory here tonight in the Veterans Classic by a final score of 59-41. It's the 25th straight season that the Gators have picked up an opening game victory. It wasn't easy from an offensive standpoint for him, but defensively, he's got to be proud of the way his team played tonight against the midshipmen.
It wasn't a masterpiece on offense, and what they showed was that if they don't force turnovers, they're going to struggle themselves in the half court. But they did enough tonight against Navy defensively, but they're going to have to work on some things in the half court.
Absolutely.
And I really believe getting Igbunu going in the low post, I think, is give them another thing that they can go to in the half court.
And on the flip side, too, we did not see Dorian Finney-Smith at his best offensively. You know, he's a guy that they're hoping for a dozen Robinson or more points per game.
No, he really struggled tonight. I mean, this kid's one of the best players in the SEC, so they're going to need him to play good every night. They're going to need Casey Hill. Again, if, when they get in transition, yeah. He's a better player. They're going to have to do that. But in the SEC, there's all different styles. Rick Barnes doesn't run that much. Then you have other teams that will push the ball before, like Auburn and Bruce Pearl.
Yep.
So it's all different styles.
Well, the alma mater, the Navy alma mater, will be performed here at Alumni Hall. The Florida Gators and the Navy midshipmen will get a chance to hear the Navy blue and gold. Being performed here at the end of tonight's ball game, where the Gators have won it by a final score of 59-41. For Mike White in his first year as the head coach of the Florida Gators, a hard-fought victory. And as we said, he was worried about this one, as you could imagine, but I'm sure excited that he got the victory under his belt. And he is on the hard court with Lauren Gardner. Lauren?
Well, Coach, how does it feel to have your first game as a Gator under your belt?
It feels good. You know, it's just such a pleasure to be at the University of Florida. It's such an honor, and it feels good for these guys to come off a long summer where we didn't have a great year, and these guys have had a chip on their shoulder, and they've worked really hard. So I'm really happy for our seniors and some of these guys that have returned. They can get off to a pretty good start. And let me just tell you, the last 72 hours has been an incredible experience for us here to get a glimpse of the Naval Academy and what these students endure and what they end up doing to defend us and allow us to have our freedoms.
We just listened to the alma mater over there. 31 points for you guys tonight off the bench. What advantage do you think that will give you guys throughout the season?
Well, we have a lot of parity on our team. We don't have four or five guys that are significantly better than the rest, and so that's the way that we're going to play. If we have six or seven that separate themselves from the pack, so be it, but that's not who we are, and we can take advantage of that by coming at you in waves and really not caring, as long as our locker room stays healthy, not caring who scores and who plays the most minutes for us. As long as Florida basketball wins, we all win.
Thank you, Coach, and congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, Lord, we appreciate that. The final score, once again, it's Florida 59 and Navy 41. For Steve Lapis, Lauren Gardner, and our entire crew, they've been outstanding this whole week. I'm Tom McCarthy. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. We want to thank everybody that was involved with the Veterans Classic. It was a fantastic 48 hours for all of us. Now let's go to New York, and Brent Stover, Doug Gottlieb, and Pete Gillen, they're in the studio. We'll go back to them right now.